Hello friends, this video on ecosystem part 21 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam.
The carbon cycle, and this we are going to discuss in detail. So this is a biogeochemical cycle through which carbon is exchanged between various components of the earth. So we will see how exchange of carbon happens between various organisms and between various parts of the earth. Now we know that carbon is something which is present inside living organisms. In fact, 49% of the constituent of any living organism is carbon. And that is why we say that all dead plants and animals are highly organic because they have high carbon content. Carbon is also present in very much abundance in oceans. In oceans, they have almost 71% carbon, which is in dissolved form. So these are the two sources of carbon. One is the living organisms and the other is the oceans, because in atmosphere you really do not have a lot of carbon. It is present around 0.04%, which is a very small proportion. So now the question is how this amount of carbon is controlled, how carbon is cycled through atmosphere, oceans, living and dead organisms. So how this entire cycle takes place. So now let us look at the important components which participate in the process of carbon cycle. So they are going to be atmosphere, biosphere, oceans and sediments. So atmosphere, like as I said, in atmosphere the carbon content is very less, but still that cycling has to happen through atmosphere. Biosphere, through living organisms. As I said, in living organisms almost 49% of it is carbon. In ocean, 71% carbon is present in dissolved form, and the sediments. So these are the four components which needs to participate, or through which carbon needs to be cycled. So let us see how exactly the cycling of carbon takes place. Going to discuss how exactly carbon will be transferred from one component to another component. Now let us start with plants. So here we have the plants here. Now these plants take in carbon dioxide during photosynthesis. Plants take in carbon dioxide during the process of photosynthesis. So in photosynthesis, plants take in carbon dioxide. So something of this sort. Let us suppose these are the plants, and during photosynthesis, this is sun. So it utilizes the solar energy to perform photosynthesis. During photosynthesis, it will take in carbon dioxide. Right, and this will perform photosynthesis. Now what will happen after that? Plants return the carbon dioxide to atmosphere through respiration. At the same time, when respiration takes place, respiration is just the opposite process. So it will intake of carbon dioxide will happen during photosynthesis, whereas release of carbon dioxide will happen during respiration. So this is how plants will give and take carbon dioxide, right? So here you can see that. Okay, now, so plants are just one component. So who takes in carbon dioxide and also gives out carbon dioxide, correct? Okay, now, decomposers also add carbon dioxide to the soil. So these decomposers, so where do you have the decomposers? So here you can see the decomposers. So these decomposers, they will add carbon dioxide to the soil during breakdown of dead and decomposed matter, because dead and decomposed matter contain a lot of carbon, and those carbon will be fixed into the soil. That is how carbon will reach into the soil. Now, so this is how carbon will come into the soil. So that is one thing. Next thing is, how will carbon dioxide come back to the atmosphere? Who all will release carbon dioxide to the atmosphere? Burning of fossil fuels, burning of wood, they can all release carbon dioxide to the atmosphere. So here you can see fossil fuels and all, they will release carbon dioxide to the atmosphere. So balance needs to be maintained between the release and the intake of carbon dioxide. So when you look at it separately, you saw that plants take in carbon dioxide and it gives out carbon dioxide to the atmosphere. Similarly, if you talk about decomposers, what do? The decomposer, they will fix carbon dioxide into the soil during the process of decomposition. Similarly, if you talk about burning of wood or fossil fuels, so all of these, what will they do? They will also release carbon dioxide to the atmosphere. Right, so these are the various steps. Again, deforestation, burning of fossil fuels, all these can cause increased rate of carbon dioxide release in the atmosphere. So we actually need to maintain a balance, and that is why we have to make sure that too much of carbon dioxide release into the atmosphere should not take place. So if you look at the overall carbon cycle, how will it look like? It will look somewhat like this. So overall carbon cycle would be somewhat like this. So here you have plants. So here you also have animals. You also have the factory emissions. So let me write it here. The factory emissions and other emissions like burning of fossil fuels, etc., etc. Now, if you see here, this factory emission will release carbon dioxide into the atmosphere. Plants will release carbon dioxide into the atmosphere during the respiration. Animals will also release carbon dioxide into the atmosphere as a part of respiration. Whereas plants will utilize carbon dioxide as a part of photosynthesis. So here the arrows indicate what is release and what is intake. So plants will take in carbon dioxide during photosynthesis. Now these carbon dioxide, now the entire cycle gets completed. How it gets completed? Because the organic carbon which is present in all these plants and animals, all these, when these plants or animals, when they die, what happens? They get decomposed, and that is when the carbon dioxide reaches the soil, and that is how the carbon dioxide will reach the soil. And again, from the soil itself, your plants will arise. So the development of plants will again take place from the soil. Now plants will arise, animals will arise, again they will release carbon dioxide into the atmosphere, and that is how this cycling of carbon dioxide will keep on taking place. So this is all about carbon cycle. So here you can see the description of carbon cycle at oceans in the aquatic system. So there also a similar concept continues. So now we will talk about the next cycle, that is the sedimentary cycle, phosphorus cycle. So phosphorus is another important nutrient. So it is a biogeochemical cycle through which phosphorus is exchanged between various components of the earth. Now what are the various components between which phosphorus gets exchanged? So the various components here would be lithosphere, biosphere and hydrosphere. Lithosphere, biosphere and hydrosphere. So what are each of these? So lithosphere is the earth, that is the soil. Biosphere is the living organisms, that is the life forms. And hydrosphere is water or the water body. So these are the components between which phosphorus gets exchanged. Now, did you notice something? Atmosphere is not there. Why? Because atmosphere doesn't play a major role in the phosphorus cycle. So there is no exchange of phosphorus takes place with the atmosphere. So the natural reservoir for phosphorus is rock, and rock is present. Rock is a part of the lithosphere. So that is the reservoir where we have maximum content of phosphorus. So phosphorus is present in the rocks in the form of phosphates. And now what we have to see is how this phosphorus gets transferred from lithosphere to biosphere and hydrosphere. So this is how.
Thank you. Please visit www.examfeo.com to watch more educational videos with a better experience. Please do not forget to like and subscribe to our YouTube channel for latest updates. Thank you once again.